The United Arab Emirates is building drone killing technology to fill its own needs, but also the country's ambition to diversify an economy that has long been dependent on oil. Signal, a subsidiary of the country's defense conglomerate Edge, is working on the technology with partners such as European missile manufacturer MBDA and Israel Aerospace Industries. Earlier, I spoke with Agnes Al Helou, who's been following the story from Lebanon. Agnes, welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
The United Arab Emirates is creating its own drone technology, and it's pretty interesting. It's using high-energy lasers. Can you tell me a little bit about that technology?
Exactly. The UAE is teaming up with international countries in order to develop the high-energy laser weapon systems. Signal, which is an Edge subsidiary in particular, has signed a memorandum of understanding with MBDA and CLS, a subsidiary of Ariane Group, in order to start developing exploration of high-energy laser weapon systems. This was announced during IDEX 2021. However, very few details were revealed. Now, Defense News spoke with Walid Al-Mismari, who is the vice president of the electronic warfare cluster and Edge subsidiary, and we know many more details about this cooperation.
This technology is not named yet, and from what you know about it, is this for smaller drones, bigger drones? Is it all-encompassing?
Okay, so this technology that is under development targets mini and micro threatening drones. 2021, before the end of this year, will mark the launch of the first running prototype of this cooperation, and it will be undergone later on testing and characterization, as well as according to the customer's needs, it will be later on customized. However, we have known few details about this counter drone solutions. First of all, is that it is a modular land-based system that due to its modular characteristics, it can be later on integrated on the second stages on sea and air platforms. It is an end-to-end counter UAV system, and it has electronic sensors as well as identification, detection characteristics, and the high energy laser. Noting that the high energy laser is not a mainstream counter drone solution. It is a very advanced technology. The UAE is targeting to explore how to use this technology. This counter drone solution will collect sensor data from various sources, and it has data fusion capabilities as well as signal analysis and jamming technologies and the destruction capabilities by the high energy laser. So the UAE is joining the club of the countries of advanced counter drone technology, and specifically the high energy laser, and it is targeting to have above market range. However, we don't know any specifications more about the range of this solution, but things will be known later on.
The UAE's defense conglomerate Edge is looking to manufacture this and export it, and they're localizing it. Tell me exactly what they mean by localizing this process.
Okay, it's not a secret that the UAE is joining forces with international countries and with other companies in order to reach localization, to move from co-production to local production. Edge CEO Faisal Al-Banai said earlier in the US-UAE Economic Council that the UAE, or the conglomerate itself, is working on joint ventures to reach Vision 2030 and to reach localization. So it's working on taking the expertise, the know-how from international companies, and starting to develop its own systems, its own new technologies. Please note that speaking about the countering drone technologies, we have to counter any drone, it's either via destruction or via neutralization, or either via taking control of the system itself. This system in particular destroys the mini and micro drones. However, the UAE and Edge and its subsidiary, in particular, Signal, have many different multiple projects. They're working also on countering different types of UAVs. And they're not only mini and micro drones, they have projects that have soft and hard kill capabilities in order to develop a local indigenous counter drone solutions. So they're working on this, and they will reach the localization not very far away, according to experts we spoke to.
As much as they're localizing their counter-drone technology and development of that technology, it's not only the UAE, they're also seeking international partners. Tell me about one of those partners.
France is a major partner for the UAE. Speaking about this counter-drone partnership between Signal, MBDA and CELES, the cooperation will take place not only in France, it will take place between France and the UAE. So each will contribute to its own part of the cooperation and of the joint venture. And noting that the UAE is also trying to target as many drones of different sizes of that fly at different altitudes as possible. So it is trying to secure all its airspace via those cooperation.
Could we see France as a potential customer down the line?
Of course, of course. Cooperation with France or with any other country means that the UAE will market, or the company, edge company, will market the solution inside the UAE, and the other company will work for the exports outside with the Western countries. So we will have a bilateral cooperation from both sides.
And it's still very early in the process. Might we see some sort of prototype in the near future?
Yes, before the end of 2021, the first running prototype will be launched, and it will undergo testing and for further characterization, as well as being later on customized according to the customer's needs. So it's not very far away to witness the first running prototype, as well as another integrated solution Signal is working on that will have also soft kill and hard kill capabilities. It will also be launched before the end of 2021. So it will mark two milestones for the company.
All right, well, I'm looking forward to seeing it. Agnes, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
You can read Agnes's full coverage on defensenews.com. And now for defense industry headlines. The Army's wrapped up an industry demonstration of a variety of possible electric light reconnaissance vehicles, otherwise known as ELRVs. The service announced that it recently held a demonstration event with electric vehicles at Fort Benning, Georgia, that could perform the reconnaissance mission. 10 vendors brought electric vehicles so the Army could test the off-road capabilities, define goals, and inform possible solutions with feedback from the soldiers who would operate the vehicles. A spokesperson added that the Army analyzed two pure electric demonstrators and several internal combustion engine demonstrators as well. The service will take the feedback to inform what could be a future prototyping program. It'll take data collected from the demonstration and elsewhere to help define characteristics and prepare draft requests for prototype proposals. Fincantieri will use all three of its U.S. shipyards to build new FFG-X frigates and will hire 600 more staff by the end of the year to handle the work. That's according to a company official. The U.S. Navy's ordered a second vessel out of a potential 10 in total. The $554 million contract for the second Constellation-class guided missile frigate was awarded to Fincantieri Marinette Marine, based in Marinette, Wisconsin. The shipyard has experience building Freedom-class littoral combat ships for the Navy. As opposed to the LCS program, work on the new frigate will also take place at two other Great Lakes sites controlled by the detailing firm. The Navy picked Fincantieri last year to deliver the first Constellation frigate, with the option for a further nine vessels in a deal potentially worth $5.5 billion to the Italian group. The new ships will be based on Fincantieri's FREM frigate, which is already in service with the French, Italian, and Moroccan navies. Polish Defense Minister Maria Splajczyk has announced its ministry by 24 Bayraktar TB2 drones from Turkey. Under the plan, Warsaw will acquire four sets of unmanned aerial vehicles equipped with anti-tank missiles. The deal is to be signed during Polish President Andrzej Duda's recent official visit to Turkey. The first set is to be delivered in 2022. The planned contract is set to make Poland the second NATO member state to operate the UAV, which is currently used by Turkey's armed forces. The drone's deployment by Azerbaijan in the country's armed conflict with Armenia last year triggered interest in the Turkish drone among Polish decision makers, according to industry observers. The Bayraktar TB2 has a flight range of 150 kilometers, according to data from Turkey's top procurement agency. Meanwhile, retired General Miroslav Rozanski, the president of StratPoints Foundation and former general commander of the Polish Armed Forces, told Defense News that Poland also needs to acquire long-range UAVs capable of carrying strikes beyond the country's borders. Last year, a spokesperson for the Ministry of Defense told Defense News that, in the long term, the Polish Armed Forces aim to acquire more than 10 sets of mid-range UAVs under the Gripen program and several sets of medium-altitude, long-endurance drones under the Zephyr program. And that wraps it up in defense industry world. When we return, personal finance expert Jeanette Mack delivers tips on summer car buying.